Trying to lose 50 pounds in just 2 months? This is how I did it.
1, 3, 2.
Hello, how are you doing today? Thank you so much for tuning into the channel. My name is Christopher Norris. This is Christopher Norris Official, where I am on a weight loss journey and my goal is to lose 100 pounds. And I've already lost a significant amount and it's only been 2 months. So the way that we do this, when you come to my channel, I'm going to tell you everything I'm eating. I'm going to tell you any supplements I'm taking. This whole board is where I keep track of my weight loss progress, measurements, goals, etc. If you are someone that's looking to lose weight or you're starting a journey, my channel would be a good place to start because I'm an amateur just like you who is also just learning as I go and succeeding at the same time. So thank you so much for stopping by. Let's get right into it. So for this week, I had a lot of ups and downs. It was a lot of work. With the holiday, Easter, and just everything going on, I didn't really change much. I just found it really hard to, really hard to lose weight this week, and I kind of hit a plateau. So what I started doing, and this is something I've been doing now for 4 days that I plan to do every day, is I'm running at least a mile every day. It only takes me about 12 minutes, 12 to 15, depending if I'm exhausted. But I think that 12 to 15 minutes a day is something that I can do and I can sustain. So I recently started doing a mile a day running outside. I do not sprint. The way that I am doing it is a brisk, you know, fast jog, almost, you know, a run kind of, but not sprinting. And then I do 15-second run, 15-second walk, 15-second run, 15-second walk. I do that the entire way, sometimes for 2 miles. If I feel that I'm needing a longer rest, I will push myself to do a 30-second run with a 30-second rest. And then immediately after that, I get back on the 15-second run to the 15-second rest. So that's something I've been implementing. However, I found online that when you start running or you start doing a lot of leg exercises, the muscles in your legs are rather large. They're some of the largest muscle in your body. So your muscle begins to, like I said, I'm not a doctor, so let me try to explain this without sounding like an idiot. If I'm wrong, please comment below. Your body produces more glycogen in those muscles, which in turn, they also absorb more water from your body, which means for, at least from what I've seen, initially for the first week, maybe two, it'll be a little harder for me to lose weight because I'm working out these muscles a lot more. And I'm perfectly okay with that. I'm thankful for the weight loss that I've gotten so far. And I think that running a mile a day, even if it slows my weight loss a little bit, I know that the overall health benefit of that is going to catch up and it's going to do more good for me in the future than it is, than it's going to do bad. So let me tell you where my weight is right now. I'm sure you saw the board. 301.8 is what I weighed in at this morning. And that is for a total of 49.4. And I know that's not 50 exactly, but that's not the point of this video. The point of this video is this is a huge weight loss in 2 months. And I have a lot of people asking me, like, what do you do? What do you eat? What do you do? I keep sending this to them to this channel. So I hope that you guys are getting enough information from me. And if there's anything missing, I think the best thing for you to do is to follow me on Instagram at Christopher Norris Official. I post a lot of my meals there. I post my workouts, selfies. And now I'm going to start posting my measurements and my weight loss before and afters for the week on there as a picture so you can see. Because when you come to these videos, the only thing you're seeing is where I started and where I'm currently at. Measurements, where I started, and these are my current measurements that I just did today, in case you didn't know. So we did do measurements, and I will say we've lost another about inch, maybe 2 inch average overall, everywhere on the body. So when you stop to think about the huge progress, if you think about the weight is one thing, but when you look at the measurements, it's another thing. So if you're losing weight and you're not doing measurements, you should, because then you'll see stuff like this. Look at this. When I started, my stomach was 60 inches. I'm down to 53 inches. When I measure my body, I'm going to the largest parts of all of those parts of my body. The largest parts, the parts that stick out the most. When I'm doing my stomach, I'm making sure I'm sticking my stomach out. I'm getting the love handles, all that stuff. So this should 100% be accurate. Anyway, other than the running a mile a day, I think I mentioned this last week, but I've been doing anywhere between 50 to 100 push-ups a day as well. I can't do a full push-up on the ground. I am doing incline-assisted push-ups anywhere I can, and I think it's a good idea for you too, because I've just noticed a significant amount of difference in my stamina when I'm boxing, in my arms, and also my strength. And if there's something that I think is important, it's to be strong as well as healthy. It's one thing to be thin and be at a good weight and not be obese, but having extra muscle on your body will only help you sustain that physique better. You know, if you haven't heard this quote, I heard it this week and it really made me stop and think. And the quote was, you know, it's really, really hard to get to your goal, whether it's weight loss, bodybuilding, if you want to be super muscular, super skinny. It's really hard to get to that goal when you're obese. However, it's a lot easier to maintain that weight than it is to lose the weight to get to that weight. So my mindset has really just been, once I get to my goal and I'm happy with my physique, it's even easier to maintain that than it is for me to lose it. And that gives me hope for the future. So run a mile, 50 to 100 push-ups a day. And I'm still doing boxing Monday, Wednesday, Friday for 3 hours, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. All this exercise has made me feel mentally clearer, and I've felt really good. The past like 3 weeks or so, about two weeks or so, I kind of hit like an emotional, like, why am I doing all this? I'm doing so good, but I'm not feeling happy. I'm not enjoying it anymore. The motivation is starting to slip. And the one thing that really helped me bust over that mental barrier is to challenge myself. And with starting this running and the push-ups, I noticed yesterday while I was running that we were running with a group. I'm not going to embarrass anybody by saying names. We were running with a small group. It was me and my brother-in-law, AJ, and someone that he brought along with him. The gentleman that he brought along with him is actually 40 pounds lighter than me, and he couldn't keep up with me while running. So that makes me feel better. And that makes me feel stronger. And it's like one of those things is like, even though I'm not as small as this person, it does make me feel good to know that I'm more athletic than that person. And I think that all the strength I'm building on this larger body will carry over into my smaller future physique and make me stronger overall, because I'm so used to carrying all this weight. And I guess that's really it. I just really wanted to get on here, tell you guys what I've been up to. I'm still eating the one meal a day. I have changed it up a lot. It's really hard for me to kind of explain everything I've been eating on these videos, because beforehand it was literally 5 or 6 eggs in a skillet, no sauce, no cheese, no seasoning, just eggs. And then it was like 2 packs of oatmeal and like some chicken breast and some broccoli. That was like my food for like the first few weeks, every single day, just over and over. I got bored with it, so I started to seek better options, because I, you know how it is. You're sitting there, you're like, I want pizza, I want donuts, I want cake. You can't have those things when you're trying to lose weight. So what I started doing was researching, what can I do to be able to enjoy these things but still be healthy and not mess up my weight loss? So lately my diet has consisted of a lot of really good recipes that I've found from different YouTubers, and especially Greg Doucette's cookbook. If you're familiar with Greg Doucette, he's a YouTube personality and also a bodybuilder, a professional. And he does really good with having low-calorie foods that are delicious and a lot of food for low calories. And you'll see that on my Instagram. I post, you know, some of his recipes, some other YouTubers, and also I've been coming up with my own. It's been really great. I literally ate pizza almost every day this week, and you guys wouldn't know that from seeing the weight loss. The pizza that I've been eating is on my Instagram, and it's about this big. It's pretty large, you know, and I get a good 5 or 6 pieces out of it. And I think that that's one of the most important things. If you're struggling, look for different options. And if you have a specific food that you're obsessed with that you can't have because you're dieting, leave a comment below and I'll do my best to try to steer you in the right direction of a healthier, delicious option. I guess that wraps it up for today. Thank you guys so much for tuning in every week. I appreciate it. I'm super excited for next week because there is two milestones, of course. We're going to hit 50, seriously. I count today as 50. It's there. However, we're actually going to hit 50 by next week. I'm pretty sure. I guess I can't guarantee it. I've never been wrong before. So you know what? Not never, but with this. So you know what? We're going to hit 50 pounds next week. And we're going to hit the 200s. And to me, I think that that is the biggest thing. Because I haven't been in the 200s. Not even 299.9. I have not been in the 200s on the weight scale in anywhere between 4 to 6 years. It's definitely been a long time that I've been struggling with this weight. And the fact that I'm at 50 pounds lost and my motivation is still skyrocketing, I feel like I found the secret. And I think that as long as you never give up and you keep working towards yourself, you'll find what works for you too. Thanks so much for tuning in. Please subscribe and turn on the notification bell. I have more content coming other than these weigh-ins. I'd like to do some extra stuff. The one thing I'm working on right now is a Q&A. You guys don't know me very well. All these videos, I just get up here, I tell you I lost weight. You don't know who I am. You don't know what I'm into. If there's anything you would like to know about me or if you have any questions about your diet or exercise and would like my opinion, please leave a comment on this video along with the other thing that I asked you to leave a comment on about. And feel free to message me on Instagram as well. Any questions, if you want to keep them private, I will keep them private when I answer them. I would like to do a Q&A video sometime this month. Thank you guys. Have a wonderful day. I will talk to you later. And don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram for the 100th time. Peace.